It is time again to begin our easy gold camo guide, and this time it is in Modern Warfare. And in the previous video, we already talked about getting easy headshots, link to that down below. So in this guide, we're going over all the other challenges to get easy gold on the assault rifles. So why not support the channel with a thumbs up? Let's get into it. First up, the challenges. The first camo you get to unlock is spray paint. Pretty easy. All you gotta do is get 800 kills, and that's gonna happen on its own as you're ranking up, as you're leveling, as you're doing other challenges. Woodland is 125 headshots. Again, we already made a separate video just for that. Link to it down below. Up next is Digital. Get 160 kills while crouching. Dragon is up next with 75 hipfire kills. Next to be unlocked is Splinter. Get 100 longshot kills. And then we move on to probably the second most difficult challenge, the Topograph. Get 100 kills while mounted. Not necessarily as hard as headshots, but it's a little more time consuming. Then it's Tiger. Get 75 kills with 5 attachments. On to Stripes. Get 50 kills while reloading. Then it's Reptile. Get 110 kills with no attachments. And last of the regular camos is Skulls. Get 3 kills without dying 35 times. So you complete all these challenges and you get the gold camo, which is under completionists. Get every assault rifle gold and you get platinum. And from there, get every default weapon, not the DLC stuff. Get every default weapon in Modern Warfare platinum, and then you unlock the final camo, Damascus. So those are the camos. Those are the challenges. Let's get into the setup. So one thing that continues from year to year is streaks you want to use. This time we get not just one UAV, but two UAVs. So intel is everything. You want to know where the enemy's at. You don't want to waste time guessing. So personal radar, UAV, and then just use whatever it is you like, something fun. I personally like Wilson, but again, at the end of the day, this guide is strictly focusing on challenges, so you want to get that intel. So the setup, this game really isn't dependent too much on your attachments, and instead it's really more about the streaks that you use, which we already talked about, the intel and the perks. So we got cold-blooded, so we don't have to deal with any streaks, don't have to bring out your launcher, don't have to worry about hiding. And we got ghost, because a lot of these challenges do require stealth and we have to have tune-up. The tune-up is going to give us a dead silence a lot quicker. You know, hey, being stealthy is going to really help you out in a lot of different situations depending on what challenge it is you're working on. And then you could use whatever lethal and tactical that you like. So some of these challenges are no-brainers. They're going to happen on their own. Spray paint, get 800 kills. Yeah, you're going to get probably more than 1,000 as you make your way to gold. There's Tiger, get 75 kills with 5 attachments. That will easily happen on its own. And then there's Skulls, get 3 kills without dying 35 times. Hey, who can't get 3 kills in a row? So we don't need to talk about those guys. But the rest, you should always try to combine them, combine the different challenges so that you're always working on 2 or more at once, sometimes 3. And so the first set, let's focus on crouching, mounted, long shots. Those 3 really work together, and you just got to get yourself in that mental state of before you mount onto a tree or a corner or a wall, whatever it is, trash can, try to crouch first. Try to crouch so that way you're getting that crouch, you're mounted, and possibly get a long shot. So the 100 mounted kills, it's very much like the headshots, except there's more emphasis on distancing yourself from the headquarters, and you want to be kind of like a buffer. You want to be overwatch between the headquarters and the enemy spawn. But if you can, try to be off to the sides or in a place where you can, you know, overwatch, overlook where the headquarters is. Okay, so here's one of my favorite spots. I use this for the headshots and it works great for mounted. Oh yeah, by the way, you can combine headshots. So you go for crouching, mounted, long shot headshots. And that's like the mentality you got to go in with this. Don't do them one by one. That's going to take way too long. Try to combine them. Try to, you know, get it into your head. I got to be crouching all the time. That, I think the crouching might be, you know, one of the top 3 hardest ones, only because you need to think about it. I normally don't crouch. I'm just running around like an idiot. But as you see this gameplay, there is one big thing in common. I am near my hard point, but I'm not on it. More of like an Overwatch kind of defending, not camping, defending. And honestly, I'll stay there as long as I can, but by the time the enemy kicks me out. And Gunrunner, God, it's such a good map. There's so many places where you can do this. And here's a great example right here. Make your way up to these rafters, and there's a great position overlooking one of the headquarters. And because there's hardly any room, you can't even stand up there. So that counts as mounted, crouched, and long shots. Long shots are really easy in this game. And I'm actually kind of mounted on the outside of the building. You can mount inside the building, but the point remains the same. You want to find yourself in these positions where you're Overwatch, you're the protector, you're the overseer, you're not camping. Okay, we're not camping. We're tactically waiting for the enemy to come by the headquarters. And while we're on that topic, yes, hardcore headquarters is the mode, as it was in the previous video for the headshots. I love hardcore. Hardcore has been great to us for many years. This game plays so slow, so we had to bump it up to headquarters. Domination just doesn't work anymore. TDM, no way. Kill confirmed is still a little too slow. It's all about headquarters. You're more than welcome to test all the other modes. I've done it, trust me. And HQ all the way. What about the long shots? You want to work on long shots? It's very similar again to our headshot mentality. Keep the headquarters to one side, position yourself to where the enemy must cross your line of sight and get those easy long shots. While you're going for the long shots, try and be crouched, try and be mounted. And once you have that mentality, that playstyle, I know this isn't running and gunning, it's a lot different, I know. But once you got that down, it's gonna come so much easier, and you're really gonna find out on your own. Having a base, having the headquarters, it welcomes the enemy into your sights, at least for two or three kills before they kick you out of your spot. So just get that into your head. How many challenges can I combine that work together? So personally, I would aim for maybe two or three challenges, but it is possible to do four and maybe even five all at once. Okay, so we know crouching, mounted, and long shots all work together. What else? So another two challenges that work great together, they complement each other, are the Dragon and the Stripes challenge, basically the hip fire and reload challenge. And a little setup, it doesn't matter which weapon it is. Extended mags, you know, obviously you're going to be hip firing, won't be as accurate, so go with the extended mag. It doesn't matter really what size. I tend to go with the basic one, so I don't slow down my movement speed too much. Sleight of hand, so that way if you know someone's going to come by, you expect enemies, you can fire off a shot, reload really quickly. Laser sight, I never ever go with the green ones because they give out your position. The red one is just fine for up close. And really that is it for all the weapons. Extended mag, sleight of hand, laser sight, and if you want to, you can add things that would control the recoil. And so let's go over a clip of the basic strategy, and it's, you know, you're gonna see a theme here of the way I like to play hardcore. And you know, I knew this guy was up here because he just killed me, so toss a nade at him. And I believe at some point here I do use dead silence. Yeah, I tend to make random shots like I just did there, random shots I can reload, get that guy. I'm not sure it was under 5 seconds, but hey, who knows. Kick off the dead silence. And people got to come here. So the overall theme is I'm hovering around the headquarters. I'm kind of by it. I don't want to flip the spawns. I'm really near. See this dude? Let's chase him down. Unfortunately, he's too far for a hip fire. But I got that intel. I got my personal UAV. Kicked off my UAV. And the UAVs really, I mean, not only do they help you, but they help your team get their intel. I see this guy, so I can set up for a nice hip fire. Do I get the reload? I don't get to reload because this guy's already here, but the extended mags just lets you spray a lot longer. And man, all these guys are popping up on the UAV. I think another dude's about to come up here. No, I see them shooting, and you know, the class sub that I've got with the ghost. It just allows me to sneak on up, hovering around, just like we do with the headshots, just like we do, kind of just like we do with everything, you know, the long shots. Batman, that overall play style, it just works with so many challenges. So all that leaves is Reptile get 110 kills with no attachments. But like I said, you can combine that with almost any other challenge, except maybe not the reload one. That would be a little bit slower. And you can play any mode you like. But you know me, hardcore headquarters all the way. And that wraps it up. So this game seems to be more playstyle dependent, whereas previous CODs were more of like really heavy on the class and the specialist, and not so much here. More, it's really heavy on the playstyle and the mode and your mentality. And I kind of like it. It's a lot different. I actually enjoy it because we've been doing the same thing for many years in a row now. What weapon should we work on next? Leave a comment below. On the left side there is a Let's Play channel. Yes, I do play other games. And on the right side, a brand new video.